desire, so they look forward to a future where they can depart the physical and biological world altogether, downloading their minds into computers and living forever in cyberspace. More recently, Beth Singler has conducted ethnographic studies of transhumanists and found that many transhumanist advocates explicitly frame the entire transhumanist goal as an effort to phase out suffering and eliminate unpleasant experiences in sentient beings. In other words, there is a feeling of alienation that stems from embodied existence, biology being stuck in ugly meat bags of mostly water.
Description of humans, sir.
But with the help of super intelligent AI and advanced robotics, AI apocalypticists look forward to a post-biological future. The singularity is a prerequisite for achieving this goal, enabling advancements in bio and nanotechnology that will help humans to achieve greater physical, intellectual, and emotional capacities, eventually resulting in a new form of existence. Alongside Ray Kurzweil, the roboticist Hans Moravec is the other horseman of the AI apocalypse. Professor at Carnegie Mellon University who has made a name for himself publishing pop science writings. In 1978, Moravec published an article called Today's Computers, Intelligent Machines, and Our Future, in which he envisioned a future where machines become increasingly intelligent and surpass human capabilities. He ends the article with a rather visceral description of a robot doctor transferring a human mind into a computer. He explores the topic more in his book, Robot, Mere Machine to Transcendent Mind, which speculates that robots will achieve a level of intelligence and consciousness far beyond human comprehension. These transcendent minds may then merge with human consciousness through human-machine integration, resulting in a post-human civilization with unimaginable capabilities. Other theorists believe we are destined for a post-biological future as well. Back in 1994, the computer scientist Marvin Minsky published Will Robots Inherit the Earth?, where he argues we'll soon be able to build bodies and brains to replace our failing biology. And the engineer Kevin Warwick, who works on interfacing computers with the human nervous system, argues against the mind upload model but says that we'll be able to enhance ourselves as cyborgs with powerful implants. Whatever the model, Beth Singler characterizes these predictions as positive forms of AI apocalypticism, an existentially hopeful vision of the future that, through technology, the architecture of the human mind and body can be transformed, free from suffering and perhaps even free from death. Singler further argues that these positive transhumanist visions of the future are patterned by the life time in and life time out. Bodily transformation was a foundational theme in ancient resurrected at the end of days, but that they'll receive new glorified bodies composed of perfected men. Perhaps the most dramatic example of this belief appears in the writings of the Apostle Paul. Paul believed in a transformed, resurrected body that maintains its physicality, but is also radically different from the earthly bodies we're currently using. In 1 Corinthians 15, Paul uses the analogy of a seed being sown and transformed into a plant, emphasizing that the resurrected body is a new creation that comes out of the old one. He says it is sown a physical body, it is raised a spiritual body. Now, the word spiritual here can lead to misconceptions about Paul's view on the resurrected body. The Greek word translated as spiritual here is pneumatikos, deriving from the Greek pneuma, which is often translated as breath. And while the word spiritual implies immaterial, Paul, along with other ancient people, had a material understanding of pneuma. It was a type of substance. Thus, the resurrected pneumatic body is quite literally composed of pneumatic substance, incorruptible matter.